Starline presents The Brass Facts.
In this episode of The Brass Facts, we're taking the behind-the-scenes tour at Starline with process manager Hunter Pilant as we learn how Starline manufactures the world's highest quality ammunition brass. So come along as we experience the process to perfection.
Okay. Hi, Brandon.
Hey,
welcome,
Hunter.
To Starline.
Thanks a lot, man. Ready to do the tour?
Let's do it.
All right.
This is 260 alloy, which is 70% copper, 30% zinc. This is standard cartridge brass, which will be the industry standard.
This is how it arrives.
This is how we get our material.
Where does it go from here?
It goes into the first draw.
First draw.
This is the first draw press. Basically, you've got a punch that's drawing this cup into a longer, skinnier cup by pushing it through a series of carbide dies, progressively getting smaller.
So what's it look like when it comes out of the first draw?
Taking this cup, turn it into that. After the parts have been first drawn, they get washed and ran through our annealing furnace. This furnace is running about 1130 degrees.
It takes it back to soft?
Takes it back to dead soft. That way we can work it again in the second draw process.
Where are we heading next?
We're gonna wash these, and then they will go back to second draw.
All right, let's go.
All right, this is our second draw process. Here we're taking our first drawn part that's been annealed, and we're gonna go ahead and get it to the final diameter and the finished wall thickness. It's gonna be the same process as far as the first one was. Punch, drawing the part through a series of carbide dies. Here we have our first trim process. They're taking that second drawn part that they've just washed, and they're trimming the excess material off of it. They're checking the parts with a snap gauge to ensure proper length. All right, right now, what she's doing is she's sorting these parts for the rings that we've cut off at the trimmers, and she's also looking for any defective parts.
This is the first time it gets hand inspected.
This is the first hand inspection. Here were the headers. Right now, they're forming the primer pocket, forming the rim, and they're also putting the head stamp on. 12 parts out of every tray are inspected for about 13 different features. They're gonna check for primer pocket concentricity, primer pocket depth, primer pocket diameter with a go, no-go gauge, rim diameter, rim thickness, length, and web thickness. And web thickness is the distance between the bottom of the primer pocket and the bottom of the case.
It's a pretty intensive inspection process.
It is. After that, we go to the head turns.
All right.
Here we have our first head turn. We're taking the headed part, and we're gonna cut some of the extra material off. From here, she's gonna hand sort these cases, and they're gonna go to the second head turn. At the second head turn, we're taking our first head turn part, and we're gonna put the finished rim diameter, rim thickness, and extractor groove on that. She's sampling this every few hundred cases. She'll sample 4 to 5.
Well, it goes through another inspection.
Another inspection. She's gonna check for rim thickness, rim diameter, and extractor groove diameter. And she's also gonna check and make sure that the rim is actually concentric with the body. From here, it goes back to the sorting table and it's hand inspected again before moving on to the venter. This machine is the venter. It's actually putting the flash hole in the primer pocket.
It's punched, not drilled, right?
It's punched, not drilled. From here, we move over to the final trim. The final trim is trimming that case down to its finished length. It's getting inspected in the snap gauge. After final trim, it'll go back to the sorting table and be sorted before moving on to the next process, which is the taper press. Several of the cases that we produce are tapered cases. This is a taper press. It's got a carbide die that is actually forming the case to a taper.
Nine millimeter.
They're checking these with a plug gauge to make sure that the mouth diameter is correct and not too large. From here, these cases are going to go to our finished inspection machine called the eye. Finished inspection machine, the eye. The reason they call it the eye is because of this fiber optic cable. If it doesn't see a flash hole, then it's hooked up to a magnetic brake that shuts the machine off. And they know that they have a part that does not have a flash hole. It's also set up with ball bearing detents on this arm. If a part comes through that's too long or too short, it'll kick out. And they know that they have a part that's of improper length.
So it's a real high level mechanical inspection.
Yes, it's a mechanical inspection.
Where do we head from here?
Polish. Here we have our finished product. This product's ready to be packaged and sent out the door to the customer.
Looks good, man. Looks really good. It's quite a process.
It is. We do our best.
So how many pieces of brass are you sending out a week?
About 3 million cases a week.
3 million cases a week. Well, I'll tell you what, I thought it was an impressive tour. Thank you for your time.
No problem.
Learned quite a bit about it. I never knew that there was so much into making a piece of brass. So, thanks a lot.
Welcome back anytime.
All right.